came out of. The first one is the Charter of Liberties in 1100 AD.
Okay.
Second one is the Magna Carta in 1215.
The third one is called the Petition of Rights. It was done in 1628. The fourth one is the Grand Remonstrance, which happened in 1641.
And the last one that we talk about is the English Bill of Rights, which happened in 1689. If you look at the Declaration of Independence, the Constitution, the Bill of Rights, you can see from these English legacy documents, and each one, like here's the Charter of Liberties, Magna Carta, the Petition of Rights, over here's the Constitution, over here's the Bill of Rights, and these sections will tell you where in the Constitution, where in the Bill of Rights. We've got something from the Magna Carta, Clause 14 establishes taxation only to the representative of council. That's in Article 1, Section 7, Clause 1 of our Constitution.
Talked about, John's going to come up and talk to you now about natural law, natural rights. Very important thing for you to understand.
And basically, it's a set of manufacturer's instructions that's built within the physical world. And it's in our nature. And we can discuss it. Humans, because they have the gift of reason, can discover what this is, right? And how they should act, right? So we can know what's in, by use of reason, what we should do, what we should avoid, and is therefore good. The first rule of natural law is to avoid evil and do good. Alright? Comes from God. There are two types of law that we're dealing with. The natural law that was given to us by God and our Creator. And it's called political law, positivist law, right, is another name for it. And this is law made by man. Political law, man's law, can conflict with that. Alright? So your legislature, your king, your emperor, you know, your rocket boy can make a law that goes against what you know to be right and what you should be doing. All right. Natural law is harmonized with, and due to knowledge and understanding. So we can understand natural law when we look at it and use reason. It begins to make sense.